हेलो एवरीवन, माय सेल्फ किशोर फरडे, मैकेनिकल इंजीनियरिंग डिपार्टमेंट, शिवाजीराव एजोनर पॉलिटेक्निक, असनगांव। इन दिस वीडियो वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट ऑटो साइकिल, लर्निंग आउटकम्स। द लर्नर विल एबल टू ड्रॉ पीवी एंड टीएस डायग्राम ऑफ ऑटो साइकिल। लर्नर विल अंडरस्टैंड वेरियस प्रोसेसेस इन्वॉल्व्ड इन ऑटो साइकिल and learner will able to solve numericals based on auto cycle. So dear student, we will discuss first of all PV diagram of auto cycle, means pressure volume diagram of auto cycle. You know, auto cycle is also called as a constant volume cycle. The auto cycle is useful for SI engine, that is petrol engine. The figure shows pressure volume diagram for auto cycle, in which 1 to 2 is isentropic compression process. So during 1 to 2 isentropic compression process, the pressure increases from P1 to P2. As pressure increases, the volume decreases from V1 to V2. The process 2 to 3 is heat addition at constant volume. As heat is added at constant volume, so V is equal to C. So 2 to 3 is heat addition at constant volume, where the volume remains constant, means V2 is equal to V3. And the pressure increases from P2 to P3. The next process 3 to 4 is isentropic expansion process. So during isentropic expansion process, the pressure decreases from P3 to P4. As pressure decreases, the volume increases from V3 to V4. 4 to 1 is heat rejection at constant volume. So during heat rejection at constant volume, the volume remains constant, means V1 is equal to V4, and the pressure decreases from P4 to P1. Now we will discuss about TS diagram of auto cycle, means temperature entropy diagram of auto cycle. So figure shows the TS diagram for auto cycle, in which 1 to 2 is isentropic compression process. So during isentropic compression process, temperature increases from T1 to T2. As 1 to 2 is the isentropic compression, so during isentropic process, entropy remains constant, means S1 is equal to S2. 2 to 3 is heat addition at constant volume. As heat is added, means the temperature increases from T2 to T3. As temperature increases, the entropy also increases from S2 to S3. 3 to 4 is isentropic expansion process. So during isentropic expansion process, temperature decreases from T3 to T4. As this is isentropic process, entropy always remains constant. And 4 to 1 is heat rejection at constant volume. So as heat is rejected during the process 4 to 1, so temperature decreases from T4 to T1. As heat is rejected, means entropy also decreases from S4 to S1. So dear students, now we will derive the formula for efficiency of the auto cycle. We know that heat addition during 2 to 3 process, that is QA, is equal to MCV delta T, means MCV T3 minus T2, where M is the mass, CV is the specific heat at constant volume, and T3 minus T2 is temperature difference during 2 to 3 process. Similarly, heat rejection during process 4 to 1 is equal to QR, which is equal to MCV T4 minus T1. M is mass, CV means specific heat at constant volume, and T4 minus T1 is temperature difference during the process 4 to 1. Now, we will calculate net work done, actual work done, which is equal to QA minus QR. So, net work done is equal to, we will substitute the values of QA and QR. So, we will get MCV T3 minus T2 minus MCV T4 minus T1. So, dear students, we know that efficiency of auto cycle is equal to output upon input. So, output is net work done and input is heat supplied. So, now we will put the values of the net work done as a QA minus QR upon heat supplied as a QA. So, after simplification, efficiency of auto cycle is equal to 1 minus QR upon QA. So, efficiency of auto cycle is equal to 1 minus, we will put the values of QR as MCV T4 minus T1 upon, we will put the values of QA as MCV T3 minus T2. So, efficiency of auto cycle is equal to 1 minus T4 minus T1 upon T3 minus T2, because M into CV and M into CV will get cancelled. So, this is the equation number A. So, dear students, for deriving the efficiency of auto cycle in terms of compression ratio, we should have to know the concept of compression ratio. So, compression ratio is defined as ratio of volume before compression to the volume after compression. So, volume before compression is a V1 and volume after compression is a V2. So, compression ratio means R is equal to V1 upon V2. So, now we will calculate efficiency of auto cycle in terms of compression ratio. So, dear student, we know 1 to 2 is isentropic process. So, for isentropic process, PV raised to gamma is equal to C. So, for isentropic process, T2 upon T1 is equal to V1 upon V2 raised to gamma minus 1. So, from this, we will get the T2 value. So, T2 is equal to T1 into R raised to gamma minus 1. Because, as per definition of compression ratio, that is V1 upon V2, we had substituted as a R. So, T2 is equal to T1 into R raised to gamma minus 1. This is our equation number B. Next, for isentropic expansion process 3 to 4, PV raised to gamma is equal to C. So, we have T3 upon T4 is equal to V4 upon V3 raised to gamma minus 1. So, from this we will calculate T3. So, T3 is equal to T4 into R raised to gamma minus 1, because V4 upon V3 is nothing but compression ratio. So, this is equation number C. So, now we will substitute the values of T2 and the T3 in equation A. So, we will get efficiency of auto cycle is equal to 1 minus T4 minus T1 upon T4 into R raised to gamma minus 1 minus T1 into R raised to gamma minus 1. So, here 1 minus, we will take the R raised to gamma minus 1 as a common term, means we will get as a numerator T4 minus T1 and denominator T4 minus T1. So, T4 minus T1 will get cancelled. So, at the end, we will get the efficiency of auto cycle is equal to 1 minus 1 upon r raised to gamma minus 1. So this is the formula for efficiency of auto cycle in terms of compression ratio. So here r is a compression ratio, gamma is the isentropic index, and for the air the gamma is always taken as 1.4. So dear students, always remember, the efficiency of auto cycle is depend upon compression ratio. As the value of compression ratio increases, the efficiency of auto cycle is also increases. But compression ratio cannot be increased beyond a certain limit, because it leads to abnormal combustion and noise during operation. So as auto cycle is used for petrol engines, therefore generally the compression ratio is taken up to 12. So dear students, in this way we had completed the auto cycle for SI engine. In your MSBT exam, the questions will ask like draw PV and TS diagram for auto cycle, or derive the expression for efficiency of auto cycle, or there will be simple numerical based on auto cycle. So I hope now all of you are able to solve these questions. Stay safe, stay healthy, stay happy. Thank you.